Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about loop control structures, video number 2. Okay, so loop control structures are discussed in this video in detail. We are taking in the previous video, we are discussing about the background story of loop control structures. In this video, we are discussing about syntax and flowcharts for doing while, do while, and for. In the next and we are taking one example for explanation. So what we need to explain is while syntax and flowchart, do while syntax and flowchart, for syntax and flowchart, write a C program to print the first n natural numbers using 3 loops. These are the things we discussed in this video. Okay, so the next is syntax for while loop. If you take any loop, initialization, condition and iterators are common. Remaining statements are changed from one skeleton to another skeleton. Okay, the first one is the initialization, followed by while we check the condition. If this condition is true, the statements are executed until unless the condition is fails. Okay, the iterator increments or decrements the value. Sometimes randomly it changes the definition of the value. Okay, so the syntax, the flowchart for this is initialization followed by condition followed by statements followed by iterator if this is yes, no, it come out of the loop. So that is what exactly here we mentioned in the loop, while loop. So coming to the do while, we are checking the condition at last. Okay, initialization, statements, iterator and while loop, and while the condition is checked at last. So the flowchart for this is initialization statements iterator condition is true then it yes if no it come out of the things. So in do while at least once the statements are executed, but while only if the condition is true, then only the statements will be executed, otherwise the statements will not be executed at least once. In do while, if the condition is fails, at least once the statements are executed. That is what exactly the pinpoint related to. So now, this is not for C language, okay? So for initialization, condition and iterator, the statements are given. So if the condition is true, the statements are executed. If the condition is false, then the quit from the block of the statements. So for this, the flowchart is initialization, condition, iterator, statements. This is what exactly the meaning of for loop. So this is when compared to remaining two flow charts, this flow chart indicates very simple way of approach. We can write only not in this way, we can also write in previous models also. It can be accepted. Okay. Now we are moving to the program. Write a C program to print first 10 natural numbers using 3 loops. We need to print the 3 loops in a sequential way. Means if I give n is equal to 10, it prints 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 you need to print. That is what exactly the object. So what I need to do, initially the first value is indicated with I and always I incremented I to 1. So automatically 1 will become 2, 2 will become 3, 3 will become 4, 4 will become 5, 4, 5 will become 6, so on. When it stops, when it reaches n is equal to 10, that is the process we are taking. So initialize int I is equal to 1, this is in while loop, int I is equal to 1. So now what condition we need to check? While I less than equal to n, so that what I need to do, I need to print the value of I. So printf percentage d I. So the next onwards, 1 is printed. Now we are going to, the value of I will be incremented. So I plus plus, or I is equal to I plus 1. Using any one of these statement, we need to increment the value. So this is the way it works out. I think you understand very clearly about while loop. So now we are moving to do while same int I is equal to 1, do printf percentage d I is equal to I plus 1 while I less than equal to n. So this is the way do while will be working. Now we are moving to the next loop control structure, that is for. So initially int I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus printf percentage d I, and it closes. So automatically it prints first n natural numbers. Okay, so that is what exactly the concept of loop control structures. Now we need to know, so while and do while are, while and do while are entry, I'm sorry, infinite loops, and for is finite loop. That is one important point we need to learn. And while is entry control loop, do while is exit control loop. While is entry control loop, do while is exit control loop. For also entry control loop. Okay, these two are the important differences. So for three loops, three things are common. One is initialization, second one is condition, third one is iterator. Similarly, here also in the for loop, this is initialization, this is condition, this is iterator. In this is initialization, this is iterator, and this is condition. So I used iterator as the keyword for making it. So generally we need to use increment or decrement in any textbook, but no textbook is defined like iterator. Why I am telling you iterator? Sometimes it increments only one value or two value, but sometimes we don't know how much value the value changes. In the latter programs you understand betterly why I am calling as an iterator. Okay, so this is what exactly the concept of this. Thank you.